Hello, I'm Suzanne, and I want to welcome you to 12 Days of Prayer for Our Nation in the run-up to the election on December the 12th. And we really believe that this is a door of opportunity, a great opportunity for a shift in government into kingdom government, which is about righteousness, it's about justice, it's about coming into agreement with God's will for the days ahead. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to make our first declaration as something of a demonstration on declaring. But that's not a limitation on you. Please use these in any way that's appropriate for you. But you know, your words and my words carry power and authority. And when God created the world, it was made when out of the power of his word. He said, let there be light. And later on in that chapter, it also says that you and I are made in the image of God. And so our words carry creative power. Now, you can actually track that theme right the way through the Bible. But another thought that I want to pull out is that it also says, in as you look from the old covenant and the shift into the new covenant, that God will write his laws on our hearts. And why is that? Now, I believe there are two reasons. One is because he is looking for a people who will walk with him, obey him, live our lives out of a love for him, not trying to obey a set of rules of where we're fearful if we get it wrong. But I believe there is another thought behind it too, because Matthew 12, verse 24, it says, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. Now, when you come into the new covenant, we become the children of God. We're seated in Christ Jesus in the heavenly realms. There is a new covenant instituted. Now, what that means is your authority and my authority has increased as we walk in agreement with heaven. And we know that Jesus himself said that he spoke the words that he heard the Father saying. And so our thoughts, if you like, what is in our hearts, shape our words, and our words have the capacity to shape our worlds. Now, a declaration comes into agreement with what God is saying, so that what comes out of our mouths shapes our world according to what he is saying and not according to the world around us. It isn't limited either into what we believe as human beings is possible. You know, what we see around us, if we take too much time to listen to the news and so forth, affects the way we think. It affects what we think is possible. And if we're not careful, it affects how we speak and what we pray. But, you know, the Word of God doesn't have those limitations on it. And lots of us in churches, we're very used to the blessing at the end of a service. The Lord bless you and keep you. Lord make his face to shine upon you. And yet, that's one of the first examples where God says to Moses, tell Aaron and the priests, Aaron and his sons, to speak this word over Israel. And clearly, he intended it to be spoken because it would make a difference. Now, in our day, I believe that there is a fresh emphasis coming and even a fresh revelation. And one of the verses that God gave me 3 or 4 years ago was Isaiah 51:16. And it says in the New King James Version, I have put my words in your mouth. I've covered you with the shadow of my hand, that I may plant the heavens, lay the foundations of the earth, and say to Zion, you are my people. And clearly he was talking about the Messiah. That was talking about the Messiah initially. But whose voice is God going to use in our day? And when you plant, you often will put a seed in the earth. So we are putting seeds in the heavens, and the word of God is a seed. You plant something because it has the capacity to grow. And we don't know whether that will be a short thing or whether it will be a long thing, term thing. But it is planting something, perhaps for the days ahead. It's a long view. But you can also read scriptures like Job 22, 27 and 28. You will make your prayers to him and he will hear you. Then you'll fulfill your vows. But you will also declare a thing and it will be established. And our words, as we speak over our nation, are powerful. And some of the answers will come quickly. Some may take time, but they are powerful in the spirit realm. And so I want you to join me as I declare this first daily declaration, this first declaration, with the knowledge that it is in agreement with heaven. There is no limitation, there is no time frame, but we are walking in God's time frame. There is a significance on this day, there is a significance on December the 12th, and there is a significant call on this nation that God is drawing out at this time. And so I based it on the scripture of the increase of his government and peace. There will be no end, Isaiah 9:6. And as we begin 12 days of prayer for this nation, we declare this is the time for God's government to be established. And we thank him and we declare that this is a time of great opportunity for his kingdom to advance. As his people pray and speak according to the will of heaven, this kingdom of righteousness, justice, truth, and mercy will clearly manifest within Westminster. We decree it will be established over and above every other rule and dominion, and that the wisdom, purpose, and heart of the King, Jesus, will be established. Bless you and thank you.